Hello all, so let's continue with the next part of this tutorial. So let's get started. So as you can see, we have started with the modeling of this particular food stall over here. So let's continue it. So now what I'll be doing over here is let's create this. So let's duplicate this. So what I'll do over here is I'll go over here and I'll just mirror it in y-axis, and I'll just make a copy of it. So after you have mirrored this stuff over here, so now what I'll be doing over here is I'll go into this convert to editable poly, I'll press 4 over here, and I'll use a bit of inset by polygons and click OK. So for now what I'll do over here is we have just assigned this glass material that is temporary, we'll just assign that over here for now. Okay, before we go with that, what we'll do over here is we'll put one swift loop over here also. So I'll go to the top view over here, select this and this, and let's just give this material to it. So after you are done with this, let's go to the top view over here and let's just take a box over here. Alright, so just duplicate this stuff and just scale it. So 1, 2, and make one more copy of it. So you want to make more copies, you can go with that. So you can just push this up, just push it in this way. Save your file. Now what I'll be doing over here is we'll move up. So for now I'll just select this and I'll just make one more copy of it over here. So I'll make one more copy over here. So we'll just duplicate this. Before we go with that, what I'll be doing over here is I'll make this over here. That's your stand over here. So for that, we'll go onto this view over here and let's take a line over here. So let's take a line over here. So go into this rendering, enable in viewport and make it thicker. After you're done, we'll go into this view over here. We'll push it more behind like this. Also, we'll take one more line over here. Like this. We'll keep it over here. Again, I will select this and I'll give a bit of fillet on it. So let's give a fillet. Again, take one more line over here. So select this, go into this and just drag it in this way. So select this, the vertices, and give a fillet like this. Same thing will go with this. Again select this and just drag it in this way. Select this and give a fillet to it. That's it. So once you are done with this stuff, so what we want is like, we'll be just increasing its thickness. So let's just increase its thickness a bit. So copy this thickness, paste this, select this, paste this, paste this. Alright, so once you're done, what I can do over here is like, I'll just push this over here. I'll select this. I'll just push this over here. In this way. Over here. So, just select this and just drag this till here. So now, can select this over here. Now, let's convert to editable poly over here. So let's convert to editable poly. And let's add one Swift loop over here. Let's go into this polygons and let's just extrude it by local normal and just click OK. So select this again, convert to editable poly, and just go into this and extrude it by local normal, reduce its size. That's it. So once you're done over here, you can just select this stuff and also we'll select this whole thing over here and just give a color on it. So select this and let's just make a copy of it for now. We'll just make a copy of that. So if you look at it over here properly, we can just duplicate this stuff up 3, 4. All right. All right. So I'll just delete this. I'll just push this up and I'll just make two copies over here. Yeah, much better. So now what I'll be doing is like over here, if you want to make such kind of this packs over here, you can create that. The top one should be much more thicker over here. So we have a pole over here, So let's go to the top view over here. If you look at it properly, so let's take again a cylinder over here. Just drag this cylinder on top of it. So reduce its radius and increase its height over here like this. Just increase its height. So convert to editable poly over here. And just add one swift loop. So select this and let's give. So before we go with that, so select all of this, just push it down, select the polygons. And let's just give extrude by local normal and click OK. So this will go with the same thing over here. It's fine. We can just select this and we can just push this up. So how we are going to create this, it's very simple. So first let's take a box over here. So let's take a box like this over here. So let's go into this, convert to editable poly, select this, again let's give extrude R and just scale that in this way. That's it. So select the bottom edges over here and let's just give chamfer over here. And click OK. Now you can just push it wide up a bit and just make one copy over here. So if you want, you can just increase its size over here. So just push it from here, here in this way and just make multiple copies over here. So just push it a bit more behind over here and just duplicate this up. So make this copies in this way and click OK. That's it. Alright. So select this all again. Save your file. So again we'll go on to this view over here. So let's take again a arc over here. So take an arc of this, select this and make this arc in this way. So after doing this, just reduce its thickness over here. So go into this effect pivot only, center to object, and just push it more down if you want. Again shift and drag and make a copy of it. Alright, so save your file over here. So just save your file. We'll need to create this leg stand. So I'll just select this. I'll just duplicate it. So select this edges over here. So select this, control click on the edges, oops, so same way, control backspace, just remove this, just push this up. So push this down also over here and let's rotate it. Effect pivot only, center to object, and just push it down. Push it over. So you can just drag it down in this way and push it inside. Alright, so save your file over here. So we'll continue the rest of the part in the next tutorial. So thanks for watching this tutorial.